Alice and Bob now, one lives in Boston and one lives in San Francisco, and they want to, they want to decide who gets the dog. And they flip a coin over the telephone.
Ah, yes.
There was no internet then. They were flipping a coin over the telephone. And the question was, the thing is that they don't trust each other. So Bob flips a coin and he says, ah, it's heads, okay. She doesn't believe him. She says, how do you flip a coin between two distrustful parties so that you're absolutely sure that it's a fair coin? So I don't know, that somehow that question was really exciting to me.
It's not every day that we get to hear from a Turing Award winner. So that's something very special up here on the Hill.
The hard work of mathematicians and cryptographers have used their exceptional skills to protect our national security.
We all know the importance of cyber intelligence, cybersecurity.
The person we have come here to hear is Shafi Goldwasser. She's a member of the National Academy of Sciences, of the National Academy of Engineering, several other learned societies. She has many honorary degrees. In my book, perhaps the highest praise one can say is that she's the co-inventor with Silvio Micali of zero-knowledge proofs, which is really a very remarkable and completely surprising phenomenon, one which is poised, I think, to have as much impact in science and in society as cryptography has had in the past.
You know that overwhelming probability, let's say one minus one over Avogadro's number. So yeah. There's really no chance in the life of this universe that you will find a mistake. That I will prove to you that the statement is correct, not by writing down in a book, but by some other new process that involves sort of, in some sense, some random challenges on your part, okay? At the end of which you are convinced that there is no way the proof doesn't exist, because if I wouldn't have been able to answer those challenges.
What seems unsolvable actually often has technical solutions that are based in origin in some basic research that was done maybe 30, 40 years ago by people who didn't know about the problem or care about it. And now, you know, it's a $1 billion industry. Everything that you are doing on the internet is signed and encrypted using this single invention. Everything that used to be in my office, in my files, on my computer, is moving to some central place. We can do computations while sort of in the dark, you know, without looking at private data of individuals. It's kind of amazing to me that I've just witnessed these things keep happening. And still, with all that, I think this is probably one of the most exciting times. If we are curious what's going to happen in 2050, I'm curious too, because I have absolutely no idea. But what I do know that if we don't invest in it now, it won't happen. Both the NSA in 2014, I think, and now the National Institute of Standards have declared that we must start planning for a post-quantum world.
I don't believe that we can live in a society where everything's open and we don't have any right to be left alone, you know, as the Judge Brandeis' famous quote. But in particular, I think that a lot of methods from originating in mathematics, going through theoretical computer science, in this field called cryptography, can offer us the ability to live in today's world, you know, with the Wi-Fi, with the surveillance, with all that, and still maintain some privacy.